Hello everyone, welcome to Coders Camp. So we are going to cover another problem from weekly contest 242, that is jump game 7. So the input given here is a string and it consists of only zeros and ones. As usual in any jump game, we are going to start from the initial index, and if we can jump to the last index, then we are going to return true. If not, we are going to return false. So what is different in this problem statement than the other jump game problems is they have given one minimum jump and maximum jump. That is, you can jump to the next position only if that position exists between these range. Also, that should be a zero. So let's understand this problem statement with an example. So in problem statement, they said the first position is always going to be zero and we can land in only zeros, not ones. So now if you check, the next position is 1, so we cannot jump to that position. Same way, we cannot jump to 2, and there is another 0 at position 3. We can jump only if satisfies few conditions. That is, it should be within the range from 0. If you add 0 plus 2, the position is 2. And if you add 0 plus 3, the position is 3. So that 0 should be in the range between the minimum jump to the maximum jump position. So yes, this zero exists in the range. So we can jump to this position. Now we are at exactly 3. So let's move on to the next one, which is 4. We cannot jump since it is 1. And finally, we have another zero, which is at index 5. So again, we are going to calculate from 3. If you add 2, the position is 5. And from 3, if you add 3, the position is 6, but anyway, that doesn't exist. So the next 0 is actually lies within the range they have given. So also we have reached end of the array, which means we have reached our last position. So in that way, we have to return true. So how are we going to approach this? So let us take this example. We are going to perform a basic BFS and check whether we can reach our destination, which is nothing but the last index in the given string. So it is said that the first position is always going to be 0. So we are going to start from the 0th index. From 0, we are going to check what are all the possible positions we can jump to. So here, the minimum jump is 2 and the maximum jump is 3. So here, the minimum jump is 2 and the maximum jump is 3. So from index 0, you can jump to both index 2 as well as 3. So both are zeros. So in that case, you can jump to both the positions. So from 0, you can jump to the index 2 as well as index 3. So once you jumped to both the indexes, we are going to check further whether we can jump to any other index from 2 as well as 3. So from 2, if you add 2, it is going to point at the index 4. And from 2, if you add 3, it is going to point at index 5. So basically, you can jump to both the position or the index 4 and 5 from 2. But they both are not zeros, so you cannot jump. So this path ends here. You cannot further proceed to search for a solution. Now it's time to check 3. So from 3, if you add 2, you will end up in index 5. And from 3, if you add 3, you will end up at index 6. So you can jump to both index 5 and 6, but here 5 is a 1. So in that case, you cannot jump, but 6 is a 0. So you can jump to 6 from 3. But 6 is actually the position where we have to land, which is the last index of the string. So we have reached our destination. So whenever we can reach our destination, we are going to return true here. If suppose we cannot reach to the last position at all till we complete the complete iteration of the string, in that case, we will be returning false. So how are we going to implement this in code? So yes, if we want to perform BFS, we need the help of our queue. So here we have a queue to help us store the positions or the indexes where we can jump to. So let's start iterating the string starting from the 0th index. Yes, we are going to start from that index. So we are going to add that index to our queue. So now 0 is added. Let's move on to the next position, which is 1. Which is actually 1. We are not going to jump to that position. So ignore that and move to the next index, which is 2, which is a 0. So now it is a 0. So we can jump to this position. We are going to check whether from the previous position, we can jump. That is, it is satisfying the minimum jump and maximum jump criteria. So the previous position in the queue was 0. So we are going to take 0 and add 2 and 3 and check whether it is in the range. So yes, it is in the range. So we are going to add that to our queue. That is, we can possibly jump to that. Same way, moving to next character, which is again 0, we can jump to position 3 as well. So we are going to add that to our queue. So now moving on to the next index, which is 4, which is 1, we cannot jump to that position, but from 0, the maximum position you can jump to, or the farthest position you can jump to, is 3. We have reached our position 4, so we can no longer jump to any other position from 0. So we don't need 0 anymore. So we are going to pop that from our queue. Now our queue is having only 2 and 3. That is, the farthest position you can reach from 0 is 3. Once we crossed that, we don't need this 0. So only then we are going to pop that from our queue. So now we are left with 2 and 3. So let's iterate the next index, which is 5, which is again a 1. So let's move. It is 6. But we have reached 5. We have crossed 5. So the maximum or the farthest position we can reach from 2 is 5. Because 2 plus 3 is 5. So that is the maximum position you can reach. We have crossed 5. In that case, we cannot jump to any more position from 2. We no longer need 2 as well. So let's pop that or remove that from our queue. So now we have left with only 3. So let's iterate. We are at now index 6, which is a 0. So we are going to check whether from the previous index, which is in our queue, whether we can jump from that position to 6. Yes, by adding 3 with 3, you can actually jump to 6, which is in that range. So we are going to add 6 to our queue. Yes. So now 6 is actually the position where we have to reach. In that case, we are going to return true. So yes, hope you understood this solution. Before getting into code, we are going to iterate our given string only once and perform a BFS. So it is going to run in big O of n time complexity, where n is the length of the given string. So let's go to code now. So as I said, we are going to have a queue first. And in our queue, we are going to add our first index, which is 0. And let me iterate the given string from index 1. So we are checking whether the encountered character is 0. Only then we are going to check the other possibilities. If not, we are anyway not going to jump. So let's leave them. I'm going to check if my queue is empty, then return false. Because at any stage, if we reach an empty queue, which means we did not get any nodes that we can reach to from that position. So we are going to check if queue is empty at any point, then we are going to return false. If not, I'm going to take the top element or the front element in my queue. So let me take that as my previous index or previous position and check whether we can reach this current position, because we are iterating only if it is 0. So if we can, we are going to check whether we can reach this 0 from the top element in the queue. So we are going to add that to our queue if it satisfies the conditions. Also, we are going to check whether we reached the last position. If we reached, then we are going to return true. If not, if at any of the position we did not reach, return true, then finally we are going to return false. So here we missed one thing, that is popping the values from the queue. So here I'm going to add one more condition. So this condition is nothing but we are going to check whether the front elements reached its maximum capacity or the maximum position it can reach to. If we cross that position, then we are going to pull them from our queue. So yes, this is it. Let's run and try. Let's submit. Yes, the solution is accepted. Hope you like this video and the solution runs in 13 milliseconds. So thanks for watching the video. If you like the video, hit like, subscribe, and let me know in comments. Thank you.